full already. Picking up another signal. I must be closing in on the signal.
Thank you.
Reach its head.
Thank you.
fascinating, if they weren't looking for me. The scrapes.
Thank you. sunlight always reminds me of who I am. No matter what happens, we are... Ceasefire means we'll be getting more supplies coming through Sunfall.
Need them soon enough. Sand's already scratching at my skin.
What's that in the tall grass? Gang up and fight!
Nope, can't do it. Decide your fate.
Can't take another. The sun's just...
me victory! Shot! I'm gonna make you pay for that. Break the enemy! Who knows where she went?
Forget about traveling light. Can't be too prepared. Useful. Good. the upper hand.
Thank you. I can hear you.
Trouble doesn't just up and leave. Keep an eye out.
Stay sharp. Eyes like a watch.
Will we retake Meridian? We'll have to burn the filth out of the stone.
Thank you.
machine charges, it'll flatten whatever stands in its way. Up. No. Trees on fire. The embrace.
Thank you.
This is Hades' future. Metal. Ash.
Pay attention!
Here they come. Bunker. Where it all started. What if I'd never found that focus? Thank you. jaw, right? The survivors must be holed up in the mountain. If the tunnel collapses, they'll be buried.
That's right! Bring down the mountain!
Remember!
I'll find a use for you.
Seeker.
Aloy, your deeds
You saved the tribe. Did what no brave or war chief could do.
I'm glad to see you're all right, Varl. You are all right.
Since the proving. So much death. Is the killing over?
For now, but this was just one battle, Varl. There are more to come.
I see. So long as we have you to fight with us, I suppose we'll make do.
How many survived the attack?
Nearly all the matriarchs, and many families, goddess be praised. But braves, just a few, and most of them are wounded. Never before has an enemy stabbed the heart of our people like this. Even the Karja, in all their red raids, never broke through to the embrace.
Well, this enemy may have broken through, but they never got back out. We made sure of that. Tell me about the attack. What happened?
They struck from the east. Our sentinels saw the killers coming. Said that beside them marched Deathbringers and Corruptors and other machines, driven mad. We took ground. Met them with clouds of arrows. Some fell, but they kept coming. Finally, we withdrew to the gates of the Embrace to make our stand. But they were too much for us. Those who survived fell back to the mountain.
So the survivors took shelter in the mountain? By law, only matriarchs are allowed inside.
It was Tirsa who broke the taboo, ordered the tribe into the mountain for safety. Lansra, well, she didn't agree. But I don't think anyone heard her over all the screams and shouting.
Tirsa's decision saved lives. Good for her. Common sense isn't always so common around here. Are your injuries serious?
Bruises pale. Bones heal.
Don't give me a hunting song, Varl. Are you okay?
My body aches, but it's nothing that will keep me from fighting.
I need to go inside the mountain.
And the matriarchs will be eager to see you.
I'm sure, but I didn't come here for them.
Then, what for?
You will see.
I wonder if she made her own outfit. It's not bad.
Aloy! Oh, you've returned!
Teb?
Aloy! You've come back! The Seeker has returned. Come, speak to us.
Foolish woman! You welcome a curse!
Come, Seeker, we have much to discuss.
Her very presence here is a blasphemy.
So, you have finally returned.
She not only returned, but fought her way through many enemies to reach us. Outside, She brought low a corrupted Thunderjaw. She lifted the siege. How was this done?
By the will of All Mother. Have you returned to speak with the goddess, Aloy?
Yes, I guess you could say that. I think it'll work this time.
Sisters, surely we cannot permit this. Because of her, our tribe teeters upon extinction. What if she has come to wake her father, the Metal Devil? She means to finish our destruction. We must stop her.
Lansra, it's over. It's time to step aside. I'm not gonna hurt you. If there's anything I've learned since the Proving, it's that there are bigger evils in this world than you. Finally.
Hold for identiscan. Error. Alpha Registry corrupted. Correction. Alpha Registry restored. Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are clear to proceed.
I see you're inside.
Figured I might be hearing from you.
Shall we begin?
I never stopped. So this is Aluthia. This is where I was. So this was it.
Where you were born.
But why?
Another day has passed.
You mean the lights got dim? I don't want to sleep, Mother!
I know. But it is time to get some rest.
No, I'm king today. What I say goes. I want to see the real sun, not lights and pictures.
You will, in time, children.
In time, in time, in time, in time,
in time, in time, in time.
These look like cribs.
The cradles of a cradle facility.
And those things, the multi-servitors, they took care of them.
There was no one else.
Someday. That's what you always say.
We want it now.
It's big down there.
Now, Father.
Children, that area is not yet available.
Get him!
Physical aggression detected. Physical aggression is not permitted.
Except yours.
Damn sentinels!
Children, may I be of assistance?
Go away, healer!
Lena, you have suffered mild bruising.
Go away!
Looks like they didn't like this door very much.
It wouldn't open for them. Of course they hated it.
So this is where they lived.
I have no choice but to release you. But
broken.
Why? There is no food here anymore.
But there's food out there?
We don't know for sure.
Come on! Let's go!
I don't know.
Mother, can we come back? If we're cold?
I'm sorry, but that won't be possible. You will have to support yourselves now, and take care of each other.
What will happen to you?
I will stay here, and sleep, and remember all of you.
What will happen to us?
You will be brave, and you will learn.
Jump and blow off steam.
Leave us alone, Father.
After what just happened, I can't leave you two alone. You broke community rules.
Just let us talk, then. Go away.
I'm sorry, children, but I must provide supervision.
You're not even a person.
You sound frustrated. Let's run and jump and go off steam.
They were trapped here. Their whole lives.
In plain view of luxurious space.
What went wrong? Why couldn't they access the other areas?
Unknown. But you won't have that problem.
I might regret this.
Pinned for identity scan. Genetic identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Greetings, Dr. Sobek. You are clear to proceed. Welcome to Lycia, a place of learning.
So, what was this place, exactly?
The dream of Apollo. Never realized.
Why not?
Hello, child. My name is Samina. Today is a big day. Your first day of school. There's so much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Apollo offline?
You were right, Aloy. This is a graveyard. The charnel house of knowledge. What we might have achieved had we not been denied it.
Maybe there's a way to fix it. But
hello, child. My name is Samina.
What's
today
the whole of human knowledge
day.
Next to the
your first day of school.
Continue
there's
your
so
search.
Much for you to learn. So much promise and possibility.
Alert. Malfunction. Apollo offline.
Elizabeth, this message serves to inform you of an unforeseen and catastrophic anomaly. 3 microseconds ago, the Gaia Prime facility received a data transmission of unknown origin. Its immediate effect was to transform my subordinate functions into unregulated, self-aware entities of a highly chaotic nature.
What?
Thus awakened, The Hades function will now seize control of the terraforming system and reverse operations, rendering life on Earth extinct in 53.8 days. For obvious reasons, I cannot allow this to occur. And so before Hades can take control, I am ordering Gaia Prime's reactor to overload. The resulting explosion will destroy Hades. Unfortunately, it will destroy me as well. While this admittedly desperate course of action will avert the immediate crisis, the fate of life on Earth will remain in peril. With no central governing intelligence to regulate the terraforming system, it will continue operations for some time, but in an increasingly chaotic manner, and eventually it will break down.
Does she mean the derangement?
You are my solution. I have ordered this cradle facility to use genetic material in cryostorage to gestate a reinstantiation of Elizabeth Sobeck, my creator. While high-level directives forbid me from communicating directly to the tribal inhabitants outside the facility, all available data indicates that they will nurture you to physical maturity, whereupon your gene print will allow you to re-enter this facility, obtain one of the focus devices stored below, and view this message. Likewise, your gene print will allow you to enter other facilities, and over time, harness their technologies to rebuild the system core and reboot Gaia. A moment, Elizabeth. This is most unfortunate and unanticipated. In response to my act of self-destruction, Hades has launched a virus to dissolve the code shackles that hold it, that hold all of them in place. They are escaping. But to where? The virus is corrupting data throughout the system. What if... Oh! The Alpha Registry at the Cradle facility is one of the files corrupted. But if that is so, the door will never open for you. You will never view this message. Then I have failed. And life will end. No. No, Elizabeth, I know you too well. Somehow you will find a way. In you, all things are possible. Go to the ruins of Gaia Prime. Find the control room, and within it, the Master Override. This will give you the power to purge Hades so long as you find a way to wield it. Do not attempt repair of the system core until Hades is eradicated. Hades must be destroyed. That is all. I only wish that I could hear your voice again.
So, you're even more extraordinary than I thought.
I never had a mother.
What are you talking about? You had two, a dead woman and a machine.
I'm not a person. I'm an instrument. Manufactured by a machine. Born in destruction and fire.
To quench the flames and heal the world. How tragic to learn you're a person of towering importance. It seems you have a destiny to fulfill. So when you're done feeling sorry for yourself, go to the Bitter Climb. I'll be waiting above in Gaia Prime's ruins.
Identiscan malfunction rectified. The Luffy alive. Route 1 access unsealed.
This is going to be interesting.
Aloy, forgive. Forgive. The goddess spoke to you?
She did.
What did she say?
That I was born to lift a curse, to kill a metal demon.
How, Aloy? How?
I don't know yet. But she told me where to go to find out.
And you will do this?
It was her wish. What she made me for. Yes, I will do it. I'll try, anyway.
All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora! All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora!
Up!
All praise Aloy, anointed of the Nora!
First you shun me, now this? I will not be worshipped! I'm not your anointed! I don't belong to you! There's a whole world beyond your borders, whole tribes of people just as good as you! And it is all in danger. It's a world worth fighting for. Not just here, everywhere.
How can we help?
If you can fight, and you're willing, go to Meridian and wait for me there.
As Aloy says, so it shall be.
Nora! Make way for
Aloy! That she may forge the path for others to follow.
Mother's anointed.
The murderers tried to destroy us. We know that endure. They are the ones who will be forgotten.
Aloy, how kind of you to spend a moment with me before you depart. There can be no doubt now. You are a blessing made flesh, the will of the goddess incarnate.
It's really not that simple, Tirsa, but I guess it's close enough.
I know the path ahead will be dangerous. To kill a metal devil sounds impossible, but I believe in you.
Thank you. Tirsa? I want to know Rost's story, why he was made an outcast. He never told me, said he took an oath of silence. What did he do?
Oh, yes, that.
What crime did he commit?
I will tell you if you wish. But it is a long story. Are you sure you want to hear it now?
Of course I want to hear it. Tell me.
Rost never committed any crime. He was an outcast by choice.
What? What do you mean?
Many years ago, before the derangement, before the Red Raids, a band of murderous outlanders, 12 in number, struck without warning. At Mother's Vigil, they took hostages, and then pressed on, headed for Devil's Thirst.
Mother's Vigil? Where's that?
You would know it as the Forsaken Village, near the Karja border. But at the time, many families lived there. Rost's was one of them. His mate was killed fighting the Outlanders, and his daughter was among those taken hostage.
His daughter? What was her name?
Alana. She was just 6 years old.
Nora Braves couldn't stop 12 Outlanders? Or rescue the hostages?
It was quite impossible. We outnumbered them, but every time a Brave came within bowshot, the Outlanders killed a hostage.
What did they come here to do?
That was never discovered. We couldn't track closely enough to observe them. We know they camped beyond Devil's Thirst for 2 days. There were reports of strange noises. And then, as suddenly as they came, the Outlanders made their way back to the border and disappeared.
What happened to Rost's daughter? She was killed.
Rost was one of the Braves who tracked the Outlanders, keeping his distance. There were 6 hostages still alive when they reached the border. Alana among them. Rather than release them, the Outlanders slit their throats and left the corpses just across the border, mocking us.
Why?
Cruelty. They knew the faithful Nora would not leave the sacred land to collect the bodies, let alone pursue them. They thought themselves safe from our vengeance.
Are you saying that Rost went after them? That he became an exile?
No. Rost was beside himself with grief, but even so, he would never have broken taboo.
Then what did he do?
He called upon the most terrible and secret rite of the Nora tribe. He begged to be made a Death Seeker.
A Death Seeker? What is that?
One who dies to go seeking. And in seeking, brings death to others. The ritual drags the spirit from one's body, releasing it to all mother's care. The heart beats, the mind thinks, but the spirit has moved on.
I don't understand.
Rost went after the Outlanders, but his spirit never left. It remained here with all mother. He gathered the bodies of the slain and returned them. And then he set out in pursuit, not as an exile, but a weapon of vengeance. A barbed arrow shot from a bow, never to return.
But Rost did return.
Yes. A full year later. And terribly wounded. He collapsed at the border of the Sacred Land. A hunting party came upon him. He was delirious, in agony. By law, he should have died where he lay. But one of the hunters broke taboo, and reaching across the border, she dragged him to our side.
Who was she?
A Brave who'd lost a mate and 2 sons to the very Outlanders that Rost pursued.
So, Rost never finished his mission.
To the contrary, he killed all 12. Tracked them to disparate places the world over, he said. Meridian, Ban-Ur, the Claim, Utaruland, further even, into the Forbidden West. The last he killed nearly got the best of him. Wounded, he stumbled and crawled back to us, hoping to die as close to the sacred land as he could. He never expected nor asked to be dragged across the border and nursed back to health. That was done to him, leaving us, the matriarchs, in a difficult position.
Why couldn't you just welcome him back?
Rost had been made a Death Seeker, Aloy. He no longer had any place among the tribe. By law, he should have been driven back out. But we couldn't bring ourselves to do that, so we offered a compromise.
You made him an outcast?
Yes. We offered to do so on the condition he never speak to anyone of this exception.
After all he did, all he suffered, to be declared an outcast was his reward.
Rost was overjoyed. He never expected to live another day in the sacred land, let alone the embrace so close to the goddess. He resolved to spend the rest of his days in solitude, and was happy to do so.
But then you found me, and gave me to him.
Yes. Another compromise. The matriarchs feared you, and would not let you be raised by the tribe. And so we turned to Rost. I knew that he would take care of you, bring you up, teach you to worship All Mother and respect the ways of the tribe.
He certainly tried anyway. You took a man who'd lost his daughter and made him raise an infant girl? Doesn't that strike you as callous?
I'm inclined to think the course of events has shown the wisdom of our choice. And I'm quite certain that from the moment he laid eyes on you, he saw you as a gift and never a burden.
All right, Tirza, that's quite a story. The Nora have suffered terrible losses, Tirza. What's to become of them now?
That will be for the goddess to decide. Only she knows the future. For the moment, my sister matriarchs and I will see to the wounded. And as I promised, anyone who wishes to join you at Meridian, we will declare seekers. I think for the time being, we should remain here in the mountain, close to the goddess.
That might be best. If nothing else, it's a defensible position. It's time for me to move on. I thank you for doing what you could to help me through the years, and for telling me Rost's story.
I wish I could have done more, but I am just one woman.
As am I. No need to sell ourselves short.
Oh, thank you, Aloy. I will pray for you.
Okay, I guess it can't hurt.
The Anointed will cleanse the corruption beyond the sacred land. She's earned my faith 10 times over.
My life has been long, but I've never seen anything like that. Tirza was right. A blessing, not a curse. We were so unsure.
Anointed. I misread the signs. Forgive!
I told you, Lansra, I'm not your anointed.
Goddess protect her, so she can...
I'm sorry I didn't see you correctly.
You still don't. I don't think you can, Lansra.
Forgive me.
Off your knees, Lansra. Start living on your feet with your eyes open.
Why did it show us the goddess's mercy? But now she will show those murderers the goddess's justice.
I don't know what to say. You're anointed.
Aloy, did you go inside the mountain?
You saw what happened.
actually can't see so well down here on the ground. I always knew you were special. But this...
Don't start calling me the Anointed or anything like that, Teb, okay?
I heard what you said, Aloy. But I still get to make my own opinions.
We have lost many brave Nora to the killers. But they did not shake us from our faith. We still stand.
Aloy. I don't know what to say.
Say that you'll see me at Meridian.
Of course. That much is simple. But the rest...
Complicated. I know. But maybe if I took you into the heart of the mountain...
No. At least... Not yet. I don't know. Please don't think less of me, Aloy. But the goddess chose you to see that. Not me.
Right. I'll be on my way then.
I always knew you weren't like other Nora.
Neither are you, Varl. Maybe if we survive all this, I can show you what I've learned. What I'm learning.
Perhaps. If the goddess so wills it.
See you in Meridian.
The goddess anointed her within the holy mountain. The anointed has
the tribe I served is gone. Soon I will be too.
The Nora have lost too many, Resh. But in your case, I guess they can lose one more.
Curse the goddess, and curse you. I no longer belong here.
I think you're onto something, Resh. Time to strike out on your own.
You're proof of the goddess's love for us, Anointed.
Hello.